This TV Mass is brought to you live by Philippine Long Distance Telephone SME Nation. Success through technology with PLDT SME Nation.
The Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat. Ngayon po, unang linggo ng buwan ng Abril. Pero sa atin, mas mahalaga ito ang ikalimang linggo ng Kwaresma. At isang linggo na lang, tayo po'y papasok na sa mga mahal na araw. Sa linggong ito, sa lahat ng simbahan, tinatakpan ang mga imahen. Tanda po ng ating kalungkutan at pagluluksa sa kasalanan na siyang naging dahilan ng krus ni Kristo. Kaya sa mga sandaling ito, upang tayo po'y maging karapat-dapat sa banal na pagdiriwang, lahat atin pong tignan ang ating mga puso. We ask the Lord forgiveness for all our sins and our sinfulness that we may enter the sacred mysteries. Let us pray charity with which I hope.
Then you shall know that I am the Lord when I open your graves and have you rise from them. O my people, I will put my spirit in you that you may live, and I will settle you upon your land. Thus you shall know that I am the Lord. I have promised, and I will do it, says the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Redemption.
Paul declared that the Holy Spirit, who is the gift of the risen Christ to us, is the guarantee of our future resurrection. Our second reading.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, those who are in the flesh cannot please God, but you are not in the flesh. On the contrary, you are in the Spirit. If only the Spirit of God dwells in you, whoever does not have the Spirit of Christ does not belong to Him. But if Christ is in you, although the body is dead because of sin, the Spirit is alive because of righteousness. If the Spirit of the one who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, the one who raised Christ from the dead will give life to your mortal bodies also, through the Spirit dwelling in you. The word of the Lord.
We give glory and honor to the Holy Gospel.
And the life, says the Lord. Whoever believes in me, even if he dies, will never die.
Praise to you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The sisters of Lazarus sent word to Jesus saying, "Master, the one you love is ill." When Jesus heard this, he said, "This illness is not to end in death, but is for the glory of God, that the Son of Man may be glorified through it." Now, Jesus loved Martha and his sister and Lazarus. And so when he heard that he was ill, he remained for 2 days in the place where he was. And then after, he said to his disciples, "Let us go back to Judea." When Jesus arrived, he found that Lazarus had already been in the tomb for 4 days. And when Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went to meet him, but Mary sat at home. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now I know that whatever you ask of God, God will give you." Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise." Martha said, "I know he will rise in the resurrection on the last day." Jesus told her, "I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, even if he dies, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" And he said to him, "Yes, Lord, I have come to believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one who is coming into the world." He became perturbed and deeply troubled and said, "Where have you laid him?" And they said to him, "Sir, come and see." And Jesus wept. And so the Jews said, "See how he loved him." But some of them said, "Could not the one who have opened the eyes of the blind man have done something so that this man would not have died?" And so Jesus, perturbed again, came to the tomb. It was a cave, and a stone lay across it. And Jesus said, "Take away the stone." Martha, the dead man's sister, said to him, "Lord, by now there will be a stench. He has been dead for 4 days." Jesus said to her, "Did I not tell you that if you believe, you will see the glory of God?" And so they took away the stone, and Jesus raised his eyes and said, "Father, I thank you for hearing me. I know that you always hear me. But because of the crowd here, I have said this, that they may believe that you sent me." And when he had said this, he cried out in a loud voice, "Lazarus, come out." The dead man came out, tied hand and foot with burial bonds, and his face was wrapped in a cloth. And so Jesus said to them, "Untie him and let him go." So many of the Jews who had come to Mary and had seen what he had done began to believe in him. The Gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Ito po ang huling linggo bago tayo pumasok sa Semana Santa. At pagpasok natin na Semana Santa, ayon sa depenisyon ng simbahan, pag nagmisa na ng Huwebes Santo, tapos na ang Kwaresma. Akala na marami ang Biyernes Santo, Kwaresma pa rin. Hindi na po. Pag nagsimula na ang misa ng Huwebes Santo, tapos na ang Kwaresma. At ito'y sapagkat, sabi doon sa Roman Missal, yung instruction ng Roman Missal, ang Lent o Kwaresma ay panahon ng paghahanda. Preparation time. Pagdating ng Huwebes Santo, hindi na ho tayo nagpre-preparation. Tapos na ang preparation, nagsisimula na ang ating celebration. Para saan ang preparation ng Kwaresma? Dalawang bagay. Unang-una, pinaghahandaan po natin sa panahon ng Kwaresma ang ating pagsasariwa sa napakahalagang gawain ng ating Panginoong Hesukristo. At ito ang kanyang pagpapakasakit, kamatayan, at muling pagkabuhay. Passion, death, and resurrection. At dyan po, yung ating ebanghelyong narinig sa araw na ito ay isang napakahalagang pagpapakilala sa Kwaresma na yan at sa Holy Mystery na yan na ating paghahandaan at ipagdiriwang. Narinig natin sa Ebanghelyo ang sinasabi ni San Juan na pinakamahalagang sign o himala na ginawa ni Jesus. Ang himala ng pagbuhay niya muli kay Lazaro na garantisadong 4 na araw ng patay. At sa pamagitan po niyan, ipinapaliwanag sa atin ng kwento ngayon, bakit ganun na lamang ang panggigigil ng mga Hudyo, lalo na ang mga leader Hudyo, na oras na upang arestuhin ang Kristong ito. Sabi nga sa dulo ng Ebanghelyo, many began to believe in Him. Mas marami ang sumunod kay Jesus pagkatapos ng himalang ito. Mas marami ang pumanig sa Kanya. At kung tatagal pa, mauubusan ng kakampi ang mga leader Hudyo. Panahon na upang dapat siyang arestuhin at alisin sa senaryo. Pero maliban po doon, ang kwento ng Lazarus, ang muling pagbuhay ni Lazarus, ay napakahalagang gateway din naman sa Holy Week, sapagkat dito nililiwanag ng Panginoong Jesus kung bakit ang ating ipagdiriwang ay Paschal Mystery, Passion, Death, and Resurrection. Hindi pwedeng ihiwalay ang death sa resurrection. Sa kwento natin ngayon, narinig natin yung opening ni Lord nung marinig niya yung message na si Lazarus ay critical. Sabi niya sa mga kasama niya, "This illness will not end in death but the glory of God." Kung isang tao'y naniniwala, alam niya na ang krus ay hindi period, hindi tuldok. Ang krus dadaan upang sa ganon maintindihan natin ang ibig sabihin ng muling pagkabuhay. Yun po yung napaagandang connection netong atin pong gospel sa atin pong gagawin na selebrasyon magsisimula sa darating na linggo. Linggo ng mga palaspas patungo sa Paschal Mystery ng Panginoon. Pero alam nyo, meron din pong isa pang napakahalagang bagay na dapat nating intindihin sa panahon ng Kwaresma. Yun ay hindi lamang tayo naghahanda upang sariwain ang pasyon, kamatayan at pagkabuhay ni Jesus, kung hindi tayong lahat ay naghahanda po upang panibaguhin ang ating mga binyag. I was going to a community. I was asking them, sabi ko, anong pinakamahalagang ginagawa ng community ninyo kapag Easter Sunday? Ang sagot ba naman sa akin Easter egg hunt. Sabi ko, kailan pa naging solemn tradition ang Easter egg hunt? No? Ang mahalaga ho sa Easter Sunday, anumang misang dadaluhan natin, it is the renewal of our baptismal promise. Papanibaguhin natin ang binyag, papanibaguhin natin ang sinasabi nating pamumuhay natin sa power ni Kristo, sa Espiritu ni Kristo. At sabi nga ni St. Paul sa ating second reading kanina, it is the Spirit of God that gives life. Nabubuhay tayo sa bagong buhay ni Kristo. Ito po yung palagay ko'y mas magandang mensahe ng Ebanghelyo. Kung nabubuhay ka kay Kristo, ano ang kwentong nais sabihin ni Lord sa gospel po natin ngayon? Na kung ikaw ay binyagan, ikaw ay nasa Espiritu ni Kristo, ang buhay pananampalataya hindi po ibig sabihin exemption sa buhay ng mundo. Tignan ninyo, nung malaman ni Jesus na si Lazaro ay critical, sabi dito, agad ni St. John, binigay niya yung komentaryo, Jesus loved Martha, Mary, and Lazarus. Sila ang kanyang pamilya. Kapag bumababa siya ng Jerusalem, dun po siya nakikituloy sa bahay ni Martha, ni Mary, at ni Lazarus. No? Mahal niya. Pero bakit nag-delay siya ng dalawang araw? Kaya nga nung ma-delay siya ng dalawang araw at intentional ang delay, pagdating niya, masama ang loob ng pamilya. Si Martha, talagang yun ang karakter niya. Agresiba. Lumabas. At diniretso si Jesus. Isa siyang babaeng diretso magsalita. Sabi niya, alam mo Lord, dumating-dating ka pa. Kung maaga-aga sana, hindi nagkaganito. Si Maria naman, sabi doon, she stayed at home. She stayed at home. May mga taong ganon na kapag napro-prostrate, nagkukulong. Hindi ko alam kung aling kayo sa dalawa. Kayo ba'y Martha? O kayo ba'y Mary? Yung iba, pag frustrated, maingay. Parang Martha. Yung iba naman, pag na-prostrate, parang Mary. Ayaw kumain, ayaw makipusap, nagkukulong. So anyway, makita natin, affected si Jesus. And we have the shortest sentence in the gospel. Sabi doon, Jesus wept. Mahal niya ang pamilya. Pero sabi nga nung iba, bakit ganun? Nakapag-ayos nga siya ng bulag. Bakit hindi niya ginawang isulba at isalba ang kanyang kaibigan? Why did Jesus allow this? Dear friends, the answer is simple. Kung ikaw ay binyagan, ikaw ay sumusunod kay Jesus, naniniwala ka na si Jesus ay resurrection and life, hindi po yun exemption sa problema. Kung hindi, the challenge in this life is that the natural process must continue. Uulitin ko, the natural process must continue. Anong ginagawa ng binyag sa atin? Baptism gives us a new perspective, bagong pananaw, bagong lakas, a new confidence to face the reality. Kung minsan, let us admit, dyan mahina ang Pilipino. Nung isang araw, meron akong kausap na owner ng restaurant. Sabi niya, Father, alam mo, yung aming gross sales araw-araw, nababawasan ng mga 5-8%. Sabi ko, saan ang bawas? Alam niyo ho, sabi niya, kasi napakarami hong gumagamit ng senior citizen card. Hindi naman senior! Kasi sa totoo lang, kung kadikit mo yung mayor, makakuha ka ng senior citizen card. Pero sabi nga niya, useless naman, Father, na makipagdebate yung waiter namin. At sasabihin, sir, hindi ka pamukhang senior. Hahayaan na lang. Pero totoo yun. Ang Pilipino, lulusot kung pwedeng ilusot. Baka sakaling lumusot. Yan ang mentalidad ni Pinoy. Di ba? Admitted. At yun ang sinasabi ni Lord ngayon. Kung ikaw ay makadiyos, ang pagiging makadiyos, huwag mong iwagayway na parang senior card. Hoy, exempted dapat ako. Exempted dapat ako sa problema. No. Dumaan si Lazaro sa kamatayan bago magkaroon ng pagkabuhay. Si Kristo, no exemption. Dadaan din dyan sa kamatayan para sa ganon maunawaan ang muling pagkabuhay. One time, I was talking to a couple friend. Natuwa ako. Pinakain nila ako. Mahilig akong kumain. Pero habang kami kumakain, sabi sa akin ng lalaki, Father, ilang taong ka na? Sabi ko, wala pa ho akong card. Hindi, sabi niya, hindi ko naman tinatanong kung may card ka o hindi, sabi niya. Tinatanong ko lang, ilang taong ka na? Kasi alam mo, Father, sabi niya sa akin, dapat nagsisimula ka ng kumain ng food supplements. Nakakatulong sa akin yun, kanya. Lalo-lalo na ikaw, Father, ang dami kang talks, ang dami kang binibigay na retreat, recollection, ang dami kang sinusulat. Naku, dapat, kanya, umiinom ka na ng food supplement para sa memory mo. Sabi ko, gandang advice yan. Kayo ho umiinom? Oo, kanya. Umiinom na ako matagal na para sa aking memory. Ano ho yung iniinom nyo para masubukan ko? Sabi ko. Kinalabit yung asawa niyang babae. Honey, ano na nga ba yung kinaka? Alam niyo po, huwag kayong ma-offend. Ang pagiging tunay na tao sa pagtanda, may package deal. Package deal ang pagtanda. Hindi ka pwedeng tumanda na flawless. Hindi ka pwedeng tumanda na ayos lahat, pati iyong mga buto-buto. Life goes on. The natural thing goes on. Ano ang mahalaga? Sana sa atin pong pagdaan uli sa kwento ng krus sa darating na linggo, Passion, Death, Resurrection. Hindi pwedeng paghiwalayin yon. Passion, Death, Resurrection. Sana yon magbigay sa atin ng spiritual vitamins na ang dapat daanan sa buhay, dadaanan. Walang shortcut. Pero ang grasya ng Diyos ay ito. Ipapakita niya na hindi lahat natatapos sa mundong ito. May kasunod. May bagong buhay. Yan. So, bago tayo magtapos, kalabitin mo yung katabi mo. Sabihin mo, no shortcuts. No shortcuts. Dadaan tayo. Amen.
Let us now proclaim our faith. I believe in God,
the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
As the celebration of Jesus' Paschal mystery approaches, let us pray to the Father that we may come to share more fully in the life that Christ brings to us through His suffering, death, and resurrection. And we call on the Lord, Lord of life, hear our prayer.
Lord of life, hear our prayer.
That the Church, the people of God, may radiate hope to the world ever in agony because of poverty, terrorism, natural calamities, ethnic wars, and man-made disasters, we pray.
Lord of life, hear our prayer.
That media practitioners may have respect for the dignity and good name of the human person as they cover events and help expose corruption and wrongdoings in society, we pray.
Lord of life, hear our prayer.
That the poor, the sick, and the handicapped may see God's presence in their lives by the support of their families and friends, we pray.
Lord of life, hear our prayer.
That those who, like Martha and Mary, suffer the loss of their beloved ones and may be strengthened by their faith in Jesus, who is the resurrection and the life, we pray.
Lord of life, hear our prayer.
That those who have died may be welcomed into the company of the saints and together sing the eternal praise of God, we pray.
Lord of life, hear our prayer.
God of life, Jesus our Lord has overcome death for us. Help us to rise from our weakness and despair, believing that nothing can ever separate us from your love through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please remain standing while the gifts are being presented.
That my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His church.
Hear us, Almighty God, and having instilled in your servants the teachings of the Christian faith, graciously purify them by the working of this sacrifice through Christ
our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as a true man, he wept for Lazarus, his friend, and as Eternal God, raised him from the dead. Just as taking pity on the human race, he leads us by sacred mysteries to a new life. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer to you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and Luis Antonio and Broderick, our bishops, all the bishops and the clergy. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with Saints Peter and Paul and the Blessed Apostles, with Saint John Marie Vianney, Padre Pio, Saint John Paul II, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we now dare to pray. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and be safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
We give to one another the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Brothers and sisters, behold our Lord Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. For those of you who are unable to receive Holy Communion, especially your brothers and sisters who are joining us in this TV Mass, we invite you to pray with us this prayer for spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Father of compassion, you let your rain fall on the just and the unjust. Give us a heart like yours, so that may love as you love, even those who have caused us pain. There is in our land a cry for vengeance, and a move to fill up death rows and kill offenders, but distinguished as a call for justice. Let true and lasting justice spring forth. Jesus, our brother, you suffered execution in the hands of the powerful, but you did not let hatred overcome you. Help us to reach out to victims of violence so that our enduring love may help heal their wounds. Holy Spirit, Lord and giver of life, you strengthen us in the struggle for justice. Help us to work tirelessly against state-sanctioned death and to renew society in truth, justice, love, and respect so that violence will cease and peace may prevail. Amen. O Mary, Mother of Life, protect the Filipino people from the forces of death. San Lorenzo Ruiz, San Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us. Let us pray. We pray, Almighty God, that we may always be counted among the members of Christ, in whose body and blood we have communion, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. We bow our heads, we pray for God's blessing. He who began the good work in you, He who began the good work in you, will be able to fulfill it. He'll be able to fulfill it. God who started the work will be able to fulfill it in you. And may the blessing of the Lord be upon you, the blessing of the Father and the Son and the Spirit of God, the Spirit of love, be with you all the way. Brothers and sisters, let us go in the peace of the Lord.